Moving on now to about number 25 of the show. So ladies and gentlemen, please firstly welcome into the red corner, representing FSC in Devon, Barry Hartle. Boxing out of the blue corner and representing Swar Muay Thai, Jack Briggs. Jack Briggs!
And here we go with Barry Hartshorn from FSC in the red corner and Jack Briggs
and will be contested in the blue corner. Muay Thai rules in the 82.5 kilogram division and has brought you this evening in proud association with Leapfrog Fight TV.
3 minute rounds this one.
Over to your referee.
5 3 minute rounds. Jack Briggs from Suar Muay Thai at the Birmingham based one. Or and FSC? No clue at all.
Oh yeah. Lost my air bubble. Thanks, Rob.
Who needs enemies when they got friends like that? I under.
Round one.
And here we go. Hartshorn in the red corner. Briggs in the blue. And here we go.
I don't know why I've got another feeling about this one. It's going to be an early finish, I think.
Knockout machines, the big boys. Here we go. 5 3 minute rounds, this one. And you know with the bigger guys that they stack power, even if it's more of a thud than a snap.
Yeah.
It's still, they still pack a punch. Just very, very cagey start, and I'm expecting the referee to say to get along with it, he'll get on with it anytime soon. What
there
do you think?
You go, yeah, yeah.
That's me, look.
You must have heard
my expertise. Told you all, Muay Thai degree by the time I finished here tonight with Thrasher. And Archon's kick just being caught, but Briggs not being able to capitalise.
No expression at all on Briggs' face.
Yep. poker match so far, this one. Yeah. Bit of a chess game.
Both guys, actually. Barry Hartshorn as well.
Yeah, a bit of a wild kick there from Hartshorn. Come from very wide stance, wide angle. Briggs replying with something of his own there.
Oh.
It's a guy attempted swipe there by Briggs to no avail. A few feints going in from Briggs. Just trying to keep Hartshorn guessing and thinking.
Nice clean work from both these guys first round.
And there we go, swing and a miss. And not a lot of action kind of happened in this first round, Andy.
Yeah, just feeling out, testing the water.
Very ironic 10-10 round.
Yeah.
In Muay Thai, yeah.
Yeah, it's very rarely the first round's ever anything different from 10-10.
Yep, feeling out round, if you will.
Unless, obviously, someone shows a distinct advantage.
Unless you're Kamal Chamberlain.
Yeah. Yeah. Then you don't need a second round.
Nope. Didn't get paid overtime, mate.
No, exactly.
As this arena is really filled out now.
Seconds out, round two.
And here we go, ready for our second round. This one's scheduled for 5-3s. And it was very much a feeling out round. Cagey first round between Hartshorn and Briggs.
Yeah, they look like they're picking it up a touch now.
Good work by Hartshorn there, just sending Briggs back to the ropes. And good leg kick there. Oh, he's chopping right hand, and if that lands, Briggs would feel it. Barry's corner just turning to hold his position. Hartshorn just retreating, but still getting caught by Briggs' kick. A lot more feints in this one. And both fighters really picking their shots.
Yeah.
Really thinking. It's very much.
Oh, that's a nice high kick.
Methodical fight so far, this one.
Yeah, it's like I said before, there's a lot of much cleaner work.
And Hartshorn just being told. Well, I've noticed the corner men are ever so passionate about everything that they do. It's a real love for the sport environment, this one, I've got to admit. Everyone involved for the love of it rather than the money or the greed or the game.
Yeah, I mean, at the lower levels, there's not really that much money in it. You know, it's only when you get to the top, I suppose, same as boxing, you know, the lower level fighters don't really make that much today.
Yep. And there we go, good, good kick by Briggs. And he's very good with his feints, Briggs. I've noticed he keeps Archer constantly guessing. And then neither of these big guys really committing with any big shots as of yet. And here, as we come down to the last 15 seconds of this one, KG affair so far. But I suppose they've had to make up for Kamal Chamberlain not waiting around or standing on ceremony in the last bout. And that concludes round two of this KG affair.
It's like a game of chicken, isn't it? Who's gonna move first?
Who can touch first? Who can get a bit of contact and get away? Yep, we'll leave it to the corners and hopefully they come out ready to fight in the third.
Seconds out. Round three.
And here we go. Ready for the big boys to hopefully catch fire in round three. Briggs starting positive there.
Corner telling Hartshorn to pick up the pace this round. Oh, that's a nice technique.
What's the term for that there? What would you call that?
It's catching the kick, but then you a little twist with the arm and the hips.
Yeah, and just like kind of like Matador and the Bull situation there.
It's more of a controlled movement and off balancing.
And they're just sussing each other out again. And oh, an attempted swipe there by Briggs. To no avail. Archer defended it well. even sure what the referee's saying there.
I think he said to start fighting, fight more.
Oh, good attempt to word that one, hit home.
Yeah.
Even though it caught it on the arm, it still felt, he must have felt something there. And there you go, corner, Barry Archon's corner, just telling him, just needs to work a bit more. Good job there by Barry Archon. And they're still sussing each other out. A kick unreplied to there from Archon.
They're both working, aren't they? But they're both kind of single shots, not really committing to combos or...
Yeah, neither of them wants the standing range. The big difference between this fight compared to the others, there'd not been much grappling and knee work.
Yeah.
A lot more rangy type of fighting, you know. Barry Archon quite well supported. Here as we come to the last 15 seconds of round three. And there, a bit of a clash of legs there. And there, that concludes round three.
Yeah.
Just waiting for this one to catch fire and catch a light,
yeah,
aren't we?
I think with the work rate and the clean shots, I think maybe a red corner's edging it.
Watch it, which way have you got it?
Seconds out, round four.
Here we are, all staying for a full house. Round four. Let's hope the big boys can catch this one alight. Briggs definitely looking like he wants to.
Oi.
Good work there.
Oh, was that a headbutt?
Okay. And there you just see Archon apologising to the referee about the head. And there we go, apologising to Briggs, and then we're back underway. And there, volley of kicks there from each fighter.
Ooh, nice uppercut elbow there from Briggs. Just missed.
And I'm unsure which way the judges are going to score this one.
No, well, I think maybe edging it to the red corner up until this round. We'll see how it goes.
And there, Briggs just always got something in response to Hartshorn's work. Just needs to work on being first, I think, a bit more.
Yeah. It was a nice counter.
Yeah, his counter work. He seems to. He's more of a counter puncher, isn't he, Briggs? He likes to wait for Hartshorn to engage. He likes to wait for Hartshorn to engage, then throw something off that.
Yeah.
And lovely shorts actually provided by Hydra.
Yeah, they're lovely, aren't they?
Did you have a special lucky pair of shorts that you used to wear, Andy?
I used to wear a pair of plain black ones, like Tyson style. Just
Mike Tyson-esque?
Yeah.
Oh,
most of the time, I got a couple of special shorts. But no, I never really bothered. I was just there for the fight in me, not the fashion.
Not the razzmatazz like myself.
No.
Not the flashiness. Good job there by Hartshorn. Needs to look to build off that as we enter the last 30 of this fourth round. I think he's definitely edging this round so far for me, Andy.
Who's that, sorry?
I think Hartshorn, Barry Hartshorn, just
yes,
the red corner.
Yeah, he's ever so slightly.
And there we go.
But I think both guys need to pick it up for this last round.
It's just not caught fire, this one.
No.
As we look at some replays there. And there, as we look at the headbutt, first of all there, the referee soon got involved and tidied up. Hartshorn soon to apologise for that one.
Seconds out. Round five.
Let's go, let's go. Come on. Fight.
And here we go. Everyone ringside encouraging these guys to put it all on the line in the fifth and final round.
They need to, don't they, really?
Last 3 minutes.
No one really standing out.
No one standing out as of yet. There we go, it seems to catch in fire a bit more. It just seems to be one of them fights that's been fought in stages rather than just consistent like we've saw throughout the night.
Yeah, stop start kind of rhythm to it, wasn't there?
Yep, and they seem to, when they do engage, they nullify each other very quickly and then went back to the feeling out stage.
Thank you.
Good shot, good elbow by Briggs. Archon back in retaliation with work of his own.
If it had swept in then, that would have won him the fight, I reckon.
Yep, I agree. And it has got to that stage in this fight that where one little significant thing could win it. There we go, referee encouraging them to get fighting as we're at the halfway point of this final round, fifth and final round. 3 minutes, this one, per round.
Now the throwing stuff that doesn't seem to have much power in any of the shots.
And the corner just saying to Barry to throw a kick and then come across with a cross. Very effective that'll be.
Ooh, first bit of clinch. Last minute. We need somebody to stick the neck out a little bit.
Yep, last minute, it just hasn't caught fire, and I think it's destined for a draw personally.
Yeah, it's looking that way.
Sometimes we do say, you know, styles make fights, sometimes they nullify fights.
Yeah,
Andy,
exactly,
and this is a case for me. And there, big last push for the last 20 seconds of this bout. And there, Archon just catching Briggs with a backhand on the back foot. A good elbow by Briggs to try and finish in the last 10 seconds of this bout. And that concludes that one. Less said about that bout the better.
Yeah, I think that's a draw.
Yeah.
We shall see.
Anyway, over to our MC for our official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five hard-fought rounds of Muay Thai action, your ringside judges have decreed that this bout be declared a draw.
Because I couldn't decide who was shittest and laziest.
I told you they're both going to moan.
It was him. He made him draw.